old do you have to be to play college soccer? Or is there an age limit to play college soccer? I'm a college soccer guy. I help you play college soccer. Let's get into it. So there are some rules here, and they get a little bit complicated. So just, I'm going to break it down for you. So just bear with me. In the NCAA, you basically have a clock. So in simple terms, and this will be the case for most of you, let's say your senior year goes by and you decide to take a gap year. Your clock has not started yet, okay? So if you decide your senior year, you graduate, you're gonna take a whole year off to study, maybe you got injured. Once you begin school as a full-time student, so you can even be a part-time student for that gap year. So as a full-time student, your clock starts. You have 5 years to finish 4 years of playing soccer. So I know that's a little complicated sounding, but basically it looks like this. Once your clock starts, you have 5 years basically to play college soccer. There is an age limit. So the bottom line is NCAA, if you're over 25 years old and you're not like in the military or you have some religious affiliation or you've been given granted because you're a refugee, you have to be younger than 25 years old to be in the NCAA. Now, in the NAIA, which is a separate league, there's technically no age limit and their rules are considerably less strict and you can play for them at any age. And the clock concept that I described to you is not the case for NAIA. You can pretty much play as you feel. It has more now to do with specific NAIA rules and some academic restrictions depending on what tests and schools you've taken, which is why a lot of internationals end up in NAIA. Regarding the NCAA, let's say you've taken that gap year, okay? Your clock hasn't quite started yet, but now it is. You've committed to Cal Lutheran, which is a Division III school, and you get injured again, or just you get injured, and you want a red shirt. Technically, this is going towards that five-year mark, but then you didn't get to play soccer, but you still have 4 years of eligibility because you took a red shirt year. But let's say you get injured again. You cannot take a red shirt year. That year will count as eligibility. So now you've only got 3 more years of school. So it's 5 years total as an eligible athlete, 4 of those in which you can play. So you can only play for 4 years. So if you take my example, mine was a unique example. So I knew that after college, I wanted to try and play pro soccer, but I wanted to make sure I got my degree. So what I did was I started taking classes in the summertime so I could graduate a semester early. So while I was playing college soccer, I joined after my senior year. I played college soccer I went to school for technically 3.5 years. So I played college soccer for 4 seasons, but I was there for freshman year, sophomore year, junior year, senior year. That's what I did. But I left my December year of my senior year. So I played there for 4 years, but come my second semester, which would have led me to graduate in May, I was already done with school. So I actually started my master's degree, and then I went to go try and play pro soccer, which eventually I did, using the same exact recruiting strategies that I'm telling you guys to play college soccer. So I know they work pretty well. In saying that, that is what the age limit restriction is when it comes to college soccer. So the bottom line is, if you want to play NCAA and you're over 25, it is too late. If you're below 25 years old, there definitely is still possible, but if you started full-time school at any point, your clock would have started, and then you only have those 5 years to play 4 years of college soccer, in which case you might be screwed and you may not get to play, in which case you should play NAI. So for all of you on YouTube, and I get a lot of messages on TikTok where I have a lot more followers at the moment, or a lot of followers, a lot of the older students are saying, is it too late for me to play college soccer? If you're 18, no. If you're 23, I would say, look, don't try and play NCAA. That's going to be a nightmare, and college coaches aren't really going to want to recruit you because you're that old. So instead, go play NAIA. But if you're an international player, and this is actually why, when you see on the rosters of college soccer teams, like, oh my gosh, they have so many international players. The reason is they recruit those kids when they're 19 or 20, and then they still count as freshmen. So now they're going to be 20, and when they're a senior, they're going to be 24, maybe even 25. On my Valpo team, we had 2 kids from Israel, so they served in the army. So technically, while they were over the age of 25, they got an exempt because they had to serve in the military. So one of them was 27 playing NCAA. A 27-year-old versus an 18-year-old gave us a big advantage. So that's why college coaches like to recruit international players that are playing at high levels abroad, because not only are they really good players, they get to be a freshman, but they're already 2 years or older than the classic freshman in the United States. And you could go, well, that's not fair, etc. But that is just how it is. I'm a college soccer guy. If you'd like more help and you're not sure about your own situation with the eligibility or whatever it might be, we primarily only help students who are in 9th to 12th grade. We do help transfers, but we have to put you in a different program for that because your issues are so complicated. And if you're an international, we don't actually work with internationals yet. We primarily only work with students abroad. We're an education service, so we're never connecting you directly to any school. We're teaching you the recruiting process.
If you'd like more help playing college soccer, I'm the college soccer guy. Links in the description, and I'll talk to you soon. Goodbye.